Empire head coach Gregg Nibert. Really a tale of two halves here tonight.
Well, it was, and then you know, that we knew they were going to try to really push the basketball the second half, and man, they got it out and went, and they really got around us, and they didn't get around us in the first half. You know, number five. I mean, they set some on-ball screens, and we just didn't keep them in front of us all night long, and like we wanted to. And he's quick and athletic, and like I said, you know, it was a tell of two different halves because of the speed of the game went a little too fast, and we couldn't keep them in front of us.
Alonzo Coleman, you know, a little bit frustrated Thursday. You guys had a little bit of a chat, and he took that challenge, and he responded to
you. Well,
that's tonight.
The hardest he's played all year. You know, that was I'm really proud of him, and that was the hardest he's played. And he was running the floor. He was sprinting the floor. He was wanting the ball, diving on the floor. And you know, that was absolutely awesome. You know, again, I don't know if we'd have lost the game if, you know, he plays with that kind of fire intensity, and hope that he can do that. And if he does, watch out. Because that was how hard you got to play in there. And there ain't no secrets on what happened, on why he had some success. It was the most effort he's played with all season long.
Coach, the point guard, we talked about how quick this guy was.
Yeah.
As he came in. He really pushed the ball hard. He can stop on a dime. And we wondered whether or not Eric Washington with a high ankle sprain, if that just didn't bother him more and more. He runs into probably the quickest point guard you've seen all year with that high ankle sprain.
Well, he is. And then what happened, too, with Eric, to give him they set that on-ball screen, and sometimes Eric didn't even know it was coming. And when you don't know that screen's coming, and, you know, half the time he doesn't use it, you got to force him into that screen, and you got to hear it, and you got to, you know, we were really going to resort to trapping him because we had such a tough time going and making him use that screen, because you got to make him use the on ball and get him into that trap. And he, on his defense, we had some plays where he didn't hear the screen was coming, and the guy, and then also they would go back and forth on the screen, which makes it tough to the guard there too, Rhett. But he is tough, and he's good, and we end up fouling him on some tough plays, and that hurt us.
And then the other thing that you always preach and you always talk about is got to make our free throws, and unfortunately tonight we struggled.
Well, we did, you know, and then that was they're 18 for 21, and we're 12 for 21, and you're exactly right, and that wasn't a – this wasn't a game where we're missing our free throws, because we've been, you know, making our free throws, especially Eric Washington. And he had he goes 3 for 5, which is, you know, he's usually 4 for 5. Alonzo, 7 for 11. Josh Clyburn, 0 for 2. You add 6 more points on there just to, you know, make it even here. Now it's, you know, 6 more points in that game. And it's still a 5, but, I mean, if you'd had 6, that was about the worst it was. You had 6 in there, it's probably a tie game And in a possession here or there, we might win the game, you know. But you got to make your free throws. And we had a couple really – we only had 4 turnovers, I think, in the first half. We had 8 in the second half. And in a game like that, you got to have 4 and 4 and give yourselves a chance, because the possessions were critical.
Yeah, we talked about that at halftime, and they turn it around on us, and they only turn it over 4 in the second half.
Yeah.
We have some pockets of things, though, that look good, Coach. We control the boards. We win that battle 29-25.
Yeah.
We win in the paint 30-20. So there's some things in there that we did very, very well, and we did have an opportunity to win this basketball game.
Well, I mean, what's happened in the – we've played the last – well, we didn't play our defense like we did against UNC Asheville. I've challenged these guys in the last week and a half to play PC defense. I mean, it's 28-26. I mean, we're diving on the floor. Coastal Carolina, we take good shots against Coastal Carolina, block them out just a little better. We beat that team. So UNC Asheville beats us by 8. We lose to, you know, Coastal by 3. And we lose to this team by, well, it ends up being 11, but it wasn't. I mean, it's a 6-8 point game or 5 or 6.
Right.
I mean, we played the first, second, and third place teams, and we feel like we've had a chance here or there to beat them. And what also we're doing, too, is, we finally got the guys we're playing are starting. But we're coming off the bench now, especially with Will Truss. He didn't get to play tonight, but he's going to play. And Eric and Ryan, and you're coming in there with 3 freshmen. And there's a little youth there that happens every now and then. But I love how hard we're playing and what we're doing. And we just got to, you know, keep it up. We can't get down. Because I feel like we can still win every game on our schedule.
Absolutely. And now we got to get ready to take a big deep breath. And then next Thursday we hit the road for a 2-game North Carolina swing. Yeah. First up is High Point.
Yeah. Well, we know we can win that game. You know, Shay Shine and Nick Barber, they killed us here. 27 and 14 points. They had 41 of their 63 points. So we got to do a great job on those guys. Again, you know, we're down 3 with a minute to go and felt like we could have won the game. Again, we had some turnovers and tough stops. But we know we can win that game. We had the lead with Campbell with, you know, 4 or 5 minutes to go here. So we know we can win every one of these games here, especially, you know, High Point Campbell, even though they're going to be tough on the road. And we got to, you know, keep getting better, take better care of the ball. But I'm so proud of our effort here in terms of the defense the last two nights and against, you know, we ain't playing the, you know, the rum-dums. We're playing the top three teams in the league. It's like I told the guys in the locker room, if we were in the Big South tournament, we would be playing for something still. It's still right. Hard, you know, on these guys, to be honest with you. That, do you guys think we could win that Big South tournament? We blitz played the top three teams in the league, toe-to-toe, the last three games. Now, we've lost all three, but it wasn't like we've lost by 10, 15, 20 right. points. So we got to keep playing, and we got to keep, you know, going here, even if it's nothing to know what we want to be playing our best basketball at the end of the season, to leave a legacy here for when we can play, you know, next season.
You know, and I know that you were in the locker room at halftime, so were your kids, so they were not able to be a part of that. But we recognized at the half 185
wow.
of the PC student-athletes
awesome.
With a 3.0 GPA in the first semester or better.
Well, that's what PC's all about, and I think we've got four or five of them that would have been out here, too, to make it
right.
over 180. You know, we got guys in there that do a great job in the classroom and couldn't be prouder of them. And you know, but that's what Presbyterian's all about. We win. We're going to win the right way, not because we have to, because we put enough pressure on ourselves as coaches and players to go in there. But we also know why we're here, to make these guys men, most importantly. I want to make them the best basketball player they can be, but I want to make them the best man they can be and also they're the best students they can possibly be and get a great degree and be the leaders in their community, the leaders in their business, the leaders wherever they are, and that's what we're trying to do here.
I appreciate you coming by. All right,
thank you, guys. Good job. That is Gregg Nibert.